we've come to our final major topic for music theory, augmented six chords. Let's start by talking about how you would spell an augmented six chord. So I have a nice step-by-step method that should work very well. Step one is to pick a scale degree where you could build a major or minor triad. That's going to be most of our scale degrees, except scale degree 7, the leading tone, which creates a diminished triad, or when you're in a minor key, scale degree 2, which is also a diminished triad. But any other scale degree should work just fine. Let's pick the key of C major, and we'll pick scale degree 5. So scale degree 5 is a G. I'm going to write a G here. I'm going to indicate that that is scale degree 5. So that is step 1. Step 2 is in the bass, make that a minor second above that scale degree. So above scale degree 5 is the one I choose. Half step above it would be an A flat. I've now completed step 2. Step 3, in an upper voice, write a minor second below that scale degree. And I'm going to indicate up the octave. So this scale degree up here, up the octave, and a half step below that would be an F sharp, such that the interval I create is an augmented sixth. Right? So here's my scale degree, half step above it, up the octave, half step below it, A flat to F sharp, A, B, C, D, E, F, so it's a sixth. A flat, normally I would, in the key of A flat major, major scale, I would go A flat, B flat, C, D flat, E flat, F, so A flat to F would be a major sixth. This is a half step higher, therefore A flat to F sharp is an augmented sixth. That's how you should be able to check that you've done this, these step 2 and 3 correctly. Now, step 4, in an upper voice, add a major third above the bass. So a major third above A flat would be a C. Right here, this is the core of your augmented six chords. That's your core, those three notes. After you've got your core of the augmented sixth chord, you have to choose the type of augmented sixth chord. And there's three different types. There's Italian, French, and German. They have abbreviations which you use for your Roman numerals, IT plus 6, FR plus 6, or GER plus 6. That's what you will use for Roman numeral analysis. For the Italian augmented sixth, you double the major third above the bass. If it's a three-voice texture, you don't need to do that, but for a four-voice, you would double it. So the Italian, you would have another C, and you would label it IT augmented six. That is not the case for the French. So for the French, you have your core, A-flat, C, F-sharp, but instead, you're adding an augmented fourth above the bass. The bass is A flat, B flat, C, D flat is your major scale. Half step higher than D flat would be D natural, so I put a D natural in here, and that makes this a French augmented sixth chord. And then finally, if I want a German augmented sixth, I take my core, A flat, C, F sharp, and I add a perfect fifth above the bass. So A flat, B flat, C, D flat, E flat. Put my E flat right there, and that would be labeled German augmented six. So how do you remember the different types of augmented six chords? Well, one way that I like to do that is to think about the music that is common between these three different, or the music commonly found in these three different countries. So in Italy, they loved opera. All the classical composers and through the Romantic era,
They loved opera. They loved the diva, the solo singer. So they really wanted the emphasis to be on melody, and they wanted harmonies to be a little bit simpler and kind of stay out of the way. So it makes sense that in the Italian, it has only three notes in it, whereas the other two have four different pitches. It's the simplest in terms of harmony, which makes sense with the whole Italian sensibility. French has this augmented fourth above the bass, providing for a very colorful, somewhat odd harmonic sound. French composers were always experimenting with unusual harmonies, unusual colorful things. The Impressionists, Monet as a painter being adopted and transformed into music by Debussy, to a certain extent Ravel, Eric Satie. So this kind of weird, think Cirque du Soleil, colorful approach is very, very French. German has the perfect fifth above the bass, meaning it's very sturdy. Think about big German steins of beer. You have that intensity that is typically German. So each one of these types kind of makes sense for the kind of personality of those countries and the music that you hear from them. So we talked a little bit already about labeling these augmented six chords. So what you do is you put the type at the top, and then you put the slash sign, just like we did for secondary dominants and secondary leading tone chords. And then, but here we put the scale degree. So instead of saying 5 of 5, we put French augmented six of, let's say, scale degree 5, right? So you might say, well, Dr. B, how come you didn't put of scale degree 5, of scale degree 5, of scale degree 5? Here we are in C major. Wouldn't you need that? And my answer is no. Just like when you write a triad and have figured bass, that the actual figured bass is 5-3, but because root position is the most common, you assume that that's there unless something else is stated. The same is true here. Of scale degree 5 is so common, you assume it if nothing is there, and you don't actually need to write it. So if we have our key signature, C major, and we know that we're going to scale degree 5, you don't need to write that underneath the type. You just put the type and you assumed scale degree 5. However, if it's not scale degree 5, you have to put it in. Just like when you have a 5 chord, 5 is assuming to go to 1. You don't need to put that because it's assumed. Now, because scale degree 5 is so commonly done, some music theoreticians like to label that core, right? So here's the core of your augmented six chords. They like to label it with scale degrees. So the bass, and I'm going to use a different color here, the bass becomes scale degree flat 6 or 6, depending on whether you are in a major key or a minor key. So let's talk specifics. Here we have C major. If you're in a major key, A flat is flat 6. If this was C minor, the A flat would be diatonic, therefore it would just be scale degree 6. So that's how that corresponds. The upper voice, a minor second below that scale degree, F sharp in the key of C major, is your sharp 4. Scale degree, these are scale degrees I'm talking about. And a major second above the bass was our C, that's scale degree 1. So why didn't I start with that? Well, because when we move forward, you come into problems. And one of the problems we already talked about. What if it's of a different scale degree? So if we do it of scale degree 1, none of this applies. And you have to say, well, what's the formula? Well, this is the formula. And as opposed to using this, which only works, the scale degree flat 6-6, sharp 4-1, that only works is if you're doing it of scale degree 5. It doesn't work for anything else. So let's learn the general principle. But be aware that certain music theoreticians will talk about augmented 6 chords using these scale degrees, the flat 6 or 6, sharp 4-1, because that's the one that's most commonly used. So don't get thrown off by that. This core, the step process I started with, is what's going to be the most useful for you. Let's see how that plays out. So here we had our Italian, French, German, all of scale degree 5. How would it be different if we did it of scale degree 1? Well, scale degree 1 is a C. So I'm going to, just for reference, put my C here and here. So I pick my scale degree, right, of scale degree 1. The bass has to be a half step above that, so it's D flat. I don't write C sharp, because C sharp is not, actually, it is a half step above, but it's not a minor second above. We specifically want a minor second above that. And we want a half step below the C up the octave, which would be a B natural. I then check. This interval, D flat to B, should be an augmented 6. It is. Hence the name of our entire topic, augmented 6 chords. I then need a major third above the bass, which would be an F. That's the core of my augmented 6 chords. All Italian, French, German have these three notes. Now, depending on which nationality, which flavor of augmented 6 chord I want, will determine what that fourth note is. If it's Italian, I'm going to add another F, right? If it is French, I'm going to put in a G natural. And if it's German, it's going to be an A flat. So we have three different possibilities there. Either F, the pitch F, G, or A flat that we add to our core. And this will give us, and we will write, if it's an F, we write Italian, superscript Italian 6 of scale degree 1. If it's a G, that's going to be our French augmented 6 of scale degree 1. And if it's an A flat, it's our German augmented 6 of scale degree 1. Okay? So, that is how we label these augmented 6 chords. The next thing we need to talk about is how they fit in with harmonic progressions. So usually, like we said, the most common is of scale degree 5. So usually it's going to precede a 5 chord. Or another option is our 1, either major or minor, 6-4. When this one chord is functioning like a 5, right? So the, as a cadential 1-6-4, cadential 6-4, it's essentially an elaborated version of 1. So usually we'll have an augmented 6 chord come right before a 5 chord, or 1-6-4. Now, reason I have this little star here, German augmented 6 chords always go to 1-6-4. They don't go directly to 5. And being the curious music theoreticians that I know you all are, you're going to ask me, Dr. B, why is that? Why? Well, let's find out the answer. Let's rewrite our German augmented 6 chord in the key of C. And let's say we label that. We don't need the of scale degree 5. We're going to go to a, I say, we're going to go to 1-6-4. Right? And so you look at that and you say, okay, well, this is going, the A flat resolves down a half step. The C is maintained as a common tone. The E flat moves up to E natural. The F sharp moves up to G. Everything is by either common tone or step. Super smooth voice setting. We're going to talk more about that in a second. So that seems like it makes sense, but why not? Why not to the 5 chord, right? Why not
just go to our 5 chord, like a French augmented 6 chord or an Italian augmented 6 chord can. What's unique about the German augmented 6 chord that does not allow you to do that? Well, just because we have all this stuff does not mean you can ignore all the voice leading rules we've learned so many lessons ago. A flat to E flat is a perfect fifth. G to D is also a perfect fifth. If you were, and you can't avoid it with a German augmented 6 going to 5. There's no other way to voice lead it. So because parallel fifths are unavoidable from a German augmented 6 to 5, you can't go there. Which is why I put right here, German augmented 6 always goes to 1-6-4. And after that, it can move to your 5 chord. Good, this is our most common, right here, this number 1, is our most common harmonic progression use of augmented 6 chords. Let's look at some other options. And then let me backtrack just one second. The reason the Italian and the French augmented 6 chord don't have that problem is because neither of them have a perfect fifth above the bass. It's only the German that has the perfect fifth above the bass. So here's just another variation of what we just talked about. Here we have our augmented 6 chord, and I didn't say what kind because it could be any one of the three, of scale degree 5. And instead of going to 5 in root position, we can insert a secondary dominant or a secondary 7th chord going to 5-6 and then resolve to, let's say, 1. So let's make ourselves be in a minor, let's say C minor, which would mean we have B flat, E flat, A flat as our flats. Our chord would be A flat. Notice I don't need to write that flat anymore because it's scale degree 6. We're in a minor key now. C, F sharp. That's my augmented 6 chord of scale degree 5. And now, how about a 5-4-3 of 5? Well, let's not, hopefully we still remember all of our secondary how to spell those chords. Our 5 chord is a G chord. So 5 of that would be a D chord. If I'm asking for 5-4-3, it's a 7th chord, so D, F sharp, A, C. I spelled that for myself, a major minor 7 chord, a dominant 7th sonority. Now, 5-4-3 means that the A is in the bass. That means that A flat becomes an A natural. I'm going to maintain the C as a common tone. I'm going to need a D by step, and the F sharp will stay as a common tone. And then, let's say I'm going to make it all the way to my 5-6 chord. 5-6 is B natural in the bass, D, G. So this A flat, normally, we have expected before for it to resolve down to a G. But here's an exception with harmonic progression. Instead of this augmented 6, A flat to F sharp, expanding out, and we're going to talk about this resolution in a second. The A flat moves up. So typically, and actually let's talk about that resolution right now. The augmented 6 interval normally expands out to the octave, then every other voice, smooth voice leading. Smooth voice leading means either by step or by common tone. This is how we resolve the augmented 6 chord. So once we get to here, then we can resolve to our 1 chord. I don't need to put the E flat because that's in the key signature. So we would have 5-6, 1, this would be 5-4-3 of 5, and if I put it just like this, that's an Italian augmented 6 chord. Let's put 2 C's.
Let's take a listen, hear what that would sound like. So, we are in the key of C minor. We go to our Italian augmented 6. And there we have it. Let me do that again and spread it out a little bit more so you can hear the bass a little bit better. Here's our home key, our tonic. Here's our Italian augmented six. Going to a 5-4-3-5. To 5-6. To 1. So that's pretty cool. And that's a great way that harmonic progression that utilizes the augmented six chord, but resolving a little bit differently than what we discussed in number one. Another option is to use the augmented six chord as a neighbor chord for five. So, what that would mean is if you have your regular five chord, you slip into the augmented six. So normally I said it precedes. Well, here it would follow and then proceed. So five, five, and here is a, let's say Italian augmented six. Take a listen. Interesting, because it might get boring to stay in five, and so they're just using this kind of like a neighbor chord to embellish and extend what's really happening all as five. So those are the three most common ways that augmented six chords are used in harmonic progressions. We already talked about the resolution. Now this resolution, the reason I put it down here is because it's very important, because you can have other bass positions. And the reason I say versus inversions is this idea of calling them augmented six chords is a little bit misleading. It would be better to call them augmented six sonorities, sounds. And the reason for that is they occur because of smooth voice leading and are considered a linear sonority, not really a chord with a root, third, fifth, and seventh, right? So if you look at how they're constructed, none of them have a seventh. The French and German are four notes, have four notes in them, but it's an augmented six interval. Let's take a look at that again so we can just see how that really works. We have here our Italian augmented six chord. Let's double that C. The way that you, all of the chords we've talked about, and all chords in traditional Western harmony, are tertial. What that means is that they are built by stacking thirds. That's how you know where the root of the chord is. It's the one that you can stack the thirds off of. Well, to do that, the root would be F sharp, A flat, C, if we were to do that. And you'd say, okay, F sharp to A flat is a diminished third. Well, and then a diminished fifth. So you would say this is our makeup. Diminished third, and actually, let me use the D here. Diminished third and diminished fifth. Major, minor, augmented, diminished, that's none of those. That's like a whole new thing, right? So you could say, well, Italian augmented six, there, I made it tertial, at least. It's not a traditional tertial harmony, but there we go. But what if I were to make the French one? So the French one has a D in it. So D, F sharp,
A flat, C. So this would have a major third, diminished fifth, and minor seventh.
That also is like none of the above of our traditional harmonies.
But let's make things even more challenging by going for the German one. Okay? The German one would be also built off of the F sharp, would have the E flat here. But
this chord, so I can stack it in thirds, I can make it tertial, but it's none of the foundational tertial harmonies we use. And it developed not as a chord, but as a sonority, as a way to move with smooth voice leading, have everything just resolved by often half steps, sometimes a whole step. Actually, almost always, for the most part, by half step. And so it's really not treated as a chord. It's treated more as a sonority. So because it's not really a chord, we don't have a root. We can't really say any one of those notes is the root. We basically put things in different bass positions. So any of the notes in the Italian augmented six may be used in the bass. So,
the Italian is the A flat C, F sharp. I could put any one of these notes in the bass and it would be okay. So I can have that. I could put the C here, then F sharp, A flat. I could have the F sharp, then the A flat and the C. All of these
would be the Italian augmented six chord. Music theoreticians do not usually require that you indicate what bass position it's in. You kind of just look at it and observe. What will have to happen though is whatever's in the bass has to have smooth voice leading. Whatever goes into it and whatever it resolves to, it must be by step or common tone. You must have the smooth voice leading. That is the critical component.
I'd like to give you one example for you to
try to do an analysis of. And so
if I would write for you the key of B flat major, I'll let you know that's what I'm doing. And I'm going to put E flat, B flat, G, C is my first chord.
And then let's say I'll go to
E natural here. G flat here, B flat here, D flat here, and then let's see, where do I want to resolve it to?
I'm going to check my notes here.
F, B flat, D natural, F, and then F, C, or F A rather, F C, and then B flat, B flat, D, F.
All right. How would you analyze this? Now, for our first chord,
E flat, B flat, G, C. Well, this is probably not.
If I try to stack it in thirds, which should work, but for the first, but as long as it's not an augmented six chord, right? Augmented six chords doesn't work if you stack them in thirds, because that won't give you the root. It doesn't really have a root. It's a sonority. So if we stack this one, C, E flat, G, B flat, well, that makes a minor seven chord, which would be exactly what we expect as a two chord. In first inversion, that makes it a 2-6-5.
So that's good. Here we got E natural, B flat, G flat, D flat. Well, that's a diminished third, diminished fifth, diminished seventh.
Well, that's none of the sonorities that we've ever talked about, right? Well, that's an augmented sixth chord. This is when you get something like this with all these diminished intervals, there's a good chance we're talking about an augmented sixth chord.
So the question that we now need to say is, okay, where's the augmented sixth? What would be our normal traditional bass? Where can we get that interval of an augmented sixth? Which we know that the diminished third inverted is an augmented sixth. So E to G flat is a diminished, that means G flat up to E would be our augmented sixth interval. So G flat, so knowing that I can reorder it, G flat, B flat, D flat, E natural. G flat, B flat is up the major third, D flat is the perfect fifth above that reordered bass. So based on that, this must be a German augmented sixth chord with the upper augmented sixth note as the bass. Going to F, B flat, F, D, that is a 1-6-4, F, A, C, 5-1. Let's hear what that sounds like. You'll notice that I don't indicate that it's not your traditional bass position. It's an alternative. It's an other bass position. Let's hear it again. Or not again, for the first time. And that sounded great. Why does it sound great? Well, the chorus, 2-6-5-2-1-6-4, which is something we've talked about many times. It's great. So what are we doing? We're just using the German augmented six to lead into it with some chromatic motion to keep interest. So instead of just going from 2-6-5 to 1-6-4, we go. And the power of smooth voice leading, something that we talked about for many, many of these lectures and how important that is. It becomes everything when you get to augmented sixth chords. And again, we really should be saying augmented sixth sonorities. This concept, and one of the beautiful things about music theory, is it's very much operating on principle. It's an overriding concept that applies to many specifics. If you take this concept of smooth voice leading, you can find other ways to go between, let's say, a 2-6-5 and a 1-6-4 that aren't augmented sixths. You can use this concept of chromatic motion, smooth voice leading, to come up with all sorts of amazing sonorities. People like Richard Wagner and Richard Strauss were masters of this smooth voice leading, using chromaticism to kind of go from one diatonic harmony to another, but in a very unique, colorful, unusual way. So as you're learning these concepts, do try to experiment. Think of them as principles that you can apply to both composing, arranging, and analyzing the music such that you can better perform it.